check out this map. Kobe is located on the southern side of the main island of Honshu, and Kobe is a vibrant port city and hub for people, information and goods from around the world. So Kobe is known as an exotic town. The population of the city is around 1.5 million. The highest temperature is 97 degrees Fahrenheit. The lowest temperature is 30 degrees Fahrenheit. So it's very warm. And our sister city is Seattle.
Kobe is abundant with nature, with access to sea and mountains. Kobe Port Tower is the symbol of the city, and from the top floor, visitors can see whole of city in a large panorama. The cityscape looks also western. Kobe also has the second largest Chinatown in Japan, called Nankinmachi.
Next, please. In Kobe, you can enjoy many delicious food, especially Kobe tea. It is one of the three major Wagyu beef in Japan. Next, please. Not only Japanese people, but also many tourists enjoy this one. If you have a chance to visit Japan, just try it.
Kobe is famous for billion-dollar night view. Next, please. Every year, a beautiful illumination ceremony is held, which is called Kobe Luminarie. This event is to commemorate the victims of the Great Hanshin Earthquake. In January 17, 1995, and it started on December 1995, the same year as the earthquake. As you can see, Kobe is a beautiful city, where it is easy to go sightseeing. We hope you can all visit Kobe one day and see for yourselves.
The next, we are going to introduce our university, Kobe Pharmaceutical University. Next, please. This is a photo of the pond called Benzen Pond, located in the middle of our university. In spring, we can see beautiful cherry blossoms around the pond.
Next, please.
Now, we will introduce about the history of our university. When our school was founded, it was women's school. And in 1994, it was changed to a co-educational school. But there are still more female students than male students now. In 2006, the pharmacy education system changed from 4-year system to 6-year system. More clinically oriented education was added to basic pharmaceutical education. In 2013, our school celebrated 80th anniversary. This is our school symbol, which originated from the Chinese bellflower.
We have 30 club activities. There are major club activities like brass band club and badminton club and volleyball club. The tea ceremony club and Japanese fencing club are Japanese traditional ones. We have school festival, which is called Kikyo Festival in autumn. There are various shops where every club activities sells food and drinks. We invite the famous singers and comedians and enjoy their festivals every year.
Thanks, Peter.
There is a botanical garden located on the top of our university. Next page. You can see apricot in spring. Next page. Chinese bell flower in summer, and persimmon in autumn, and Christmas rose in winter. So we can see various plants seasonally. And also, they grow medical house here. Next page. Our school was built on a hill, and we walk up steep slope every day. It's so hard, but next page. But we can see some really beautiful views. The night view is so great. This picture is the overlooked scenery from our school. We enjoy our school days at the university surrounded by a splendid environment. Thank you for listening.
Next one, fourth year's presentation is okay.
We hope you can enjoy and you enjoy it and you sometimes you come to Kobe in business. Thank you very much.
Okay.
We start the presentation about pharmaceutical education in Japan. This is our outline. Curriculum, first and second year, third and fourth year, fifth and sixth year, how to become a pharmacist in Japan, national examination for a pharmacist in Japan, the pharmacist license in Japan. This is the curriculum in KPU. We study basic education and specialized subject until fourth year. At fourth year, we become a member of laboratory and research in each laboratory. At fifth year, we carry out the clinical training. It is like your rotation. Next, we explain in detail about our curriculum.
During the first 3 years, we study basic subjects such as chemistry, biology, and physics. It's a lecture style. We learn how medicines act in human body. In the second year, in addition to the basic subjects, we study hygiene and infection control. Laboratory training starts in the second year. Through the experiments in the laboratory training, we deepen our understandings of the lecture we took before.
Next, I will explain about pharmaceutical education third to fourth year. First, third year, we learn pharmacology, pharmacotherapeutics, medical chemistry, pharmacokinetics, and the like at third year. We obtain basic skills we obtain basic skills as healthcare professional by learning these subjects. We learn a lot of special subjects at third year, and studying is very hard. Next, fourth year, we learn preclinical training and clinical English at the fourth year. We obtain skills to be able to work in an internationalized society. And we have examination to assess our
we have examination to see that we are eligible to participate in clinical training at fifth year. These examinations are called CBT and OSCE. CBT is an examination to assess our knowledge. OSCE is an examination to assess our skills and attitude as pharmacists. I took these tests four months ago. I got very nervous in the test. We must pass these examination, otherwise we can't participate clinical training at fifth year. Next, please.
At fifth year, we participate in training at the hospital and local pharmacy for 11 weeks respectively. And we learn know-how as a pharmacist. And we are on campus. We do research as graduation study. There are about 20 laboratories in KPU. Students belong to one of the laboratories, such as organic chemistry, physical chemistry, biochemistry, and so on. At sixth year, we prepared for national examination. We have intensive classes for national examination in KPU, and we study very hard for the examination until the end of the school year.
That's good. Do you know how to be a pharmacist in Japan? Next, please. First of all, we need to go to the university that has curriculum for learning pharmacy after graduation from high school. Next, please. We have 74 national, public, private, the pharmaceutical university in Japan. Usually, it takes six years to complete this course. And after we complete that year course, we can take a national examination to be a pharmacist. If we pass the test, we become a pharmacist. Japanese pharmacist works in hospitals, pharmacists, the drug industries, and so on.
I'd like to explain about the national examination for pharmacists in Japan. It's a standard examination created by the Ministry of Health, Labor and Welfare to assess an individual competency and knowledge so that he or she may be given the license to practice pharmacy in Japan. The subjects of examination are written here. And this test is held in March once a year. And there are 345 questions in this exam. And this testing method is computer-granted multiple-choice test. After we graduate from pharmaceutical universities, we will take this exam. Next, please. Next is about the pharmacist license in Japan. This license is given by the Ministry of Health, Labor and Welfare. If we pass the national examination for pharmacists, we will be able to get the license and work as a pharmacist. This license can be used in Japan and does not need to be renewed. It's valid for life. Maybe it's different from American. That's all. Thank you very much for listening.